Thank you for watching, and in this video I'm going to cover move, copy, rotate, scale and stretch command. Right now I have this sketch, so I'm gonna start it. Suppose you want to move this line. So what you are gonna do is you are just gonna hold this line and moving, but it's just changing the length and changing the design, as you can see. Okay, there is another way. What you can do is you can just select all the sketch and then you can hold from anywhere and then you can move it. Okay, so this is another way. But if you really want to do it scientifically, so there is a command like which can do a multiple things for you. What I can do is I can go into the sketch tab, and in the ribbon section there is a tool which is called move entities. So in the move entities there are five more options. One is move entities, copy entities, rotate entities, scale entities and stretch entities. So let's go into move entities first. Okay, so in the move entities you can see we need to just select what is the sketch we want to move, and then there is an option keep relation. So check this keep relation option, so in that way the sketch is not going to disturb. And then the second thing is parameters. So for the parameters, the one thing is you can just use a point from to, or you can choose x and y. In the manual section then you need to choose the change in x and change in y, but that is a bit critical, so I would say just choose the one point from and to. And then here you can choose, click on it and choose a starting point. Just I'm gonna start this point. First I'm gonna choose the whole sketch which I want to move. So keep relations, check, and then I'm gonna select the whole sketch. It's gonna select it, and then I'm gonna go into the start point and I would just start this point. And after that, when I'm gonna click any point, so after that you are gonna see the whole sketch is just sticking to my cursor. So wherever I gonna go and click, the whole sketch will move there. Like I'm gonna click on here, so this sketch is moved from here to here. It looks very simple, but the thing is, like, if you have a big and complex sketch then it's gonna help you a lot without changing or without disturbing the relation and everything. So this was the first, moving, and the next thing is copy entities. So what I can do is I can go into the copy entities again, copies entities to copy. So I would select the whole sketch. It is all selected, and keep the relations. And then what I can do is, like, again I can go from to from. So in the starting point I would go. So what I can do is I want to copy the entities. So what I can do is I just select this point and then I can bring it wherever I want. Suppose I want to bring it to the origin. So look, the whole sketch is gonna copy it from this point to this point. So we have a, this is the original one and this is the copied one. So in this way we can create a different copy. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would found a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. Okay, the next option, we can go into rotate entities. Okay, so again I need to select what sketch I want to rotate. I can select the whole sketch and then keep relations, and then center of rotation. I need to choose a center of rotation. So what I can do is I can just choose the center of rotation. You can choose any point, like at what point you want to rotate. If I'm gonna say I want to rotate at this point, so, and then I need to give the degree, like how many degree I want to rotate. Suppose I want to rotate 5 degrees, it's gonna rotate. If I want to move 15 degrees, or if you want to say like you want to rotate 45 degrees, so it's gonna rotate. Look, the thing is, like, right now in this sketch there is a relation between the lines. This is a horizontal relation, this is a perpendicular line, perpendicular, horizontal, horizontal. So the thing is, like, right now because this is gonna be rotated everything, so this is not horizontal or this is not perpendicular. But if you are gonna add a relation between two lines, if both relations are gonna move, the relation would be always there. Suppose I want to make a relation between this line and this line. So what I can do is I can make a perpendicular relation between them. So you can see a small tiny perpendicular symbol. So if I want to go and I want to rotate it, Again, I can select the whole sketch I want to rotate, and then center of the rotation I can rotate up around this center, and then suppose I want to rotate at minus 20 degree. Look, the relation, it's the whole sketch is moved from 45 to minus 20, like it's almost 25 degree now. So, but the relation is still there. So this is my point. If the relation, if the both things are gonna rotate, so relation would be still there. Okay, then we can go into the next option, which is scale entities. Okay, again, we need to choose what entity I want to scale. I'm gonna select the whole sketch, and then what I can do is, like, I can just scale about. So at what point I want to scale, I want to start from this point, and then I need to select how much I want to scale. Suppose I want to scale 10. So it's gonna be huge if I want to scale 2. Okay, if I want to scale 1.5, I can just, there is an option, I can just check this mark, copy. So what the thing is, like, the whole sketch is gonna be copied here. So this is another option, so it's up to you. So I'm gonna click green check mark. Okay, we are gonna go and see the next option. So next is the stretch entities. So what I can do is, I can select the whole sketch if I want to stretch, or what I can do is I can just select these lines, 1, 2, 3. I can select these lines, and then I would say I want to stretch it from 2, and I can select this center, and then I can stretch around this point. I can stretch, I can bring them wherever I want. Suppose I want to stretch them like this. Look, this is my sketch right now. So I would say this is pretty useful when you have complex sketches and then you want to apply multiple things like move, sketch, stretch, or whatever. This is a really handy tool in such kind of situations. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.